does your birth month, the month you were born in, does that affect the diseases that you'll develop in your lifetime? So there's large amounts of new clinical data becoming available every day. Every time we go to the doctor, we get a prescription filled, data's being recorded about us, our hospital's recording data about us, and we can use that data to study what happens when patients take drugs, what adverse events occur, what drugs work for them, and what drugs don't. We had a very large clinical data set here at Columbia University Medical Center of approximately 1.7 million patients, people who have been born from 1900 to 2000, have been seen in our hospital. And we examined 1,600 diseases approximately for birth month dependencies. And we looked for significant deviations where there were particular months or seasons of the year that seemed to indicate a higher risk of developing a particular disease. Overall, what we found is that there are high risk months to be born and low risk months. The lowest risk we found was in May, and the highest risk was actually in October and November. Those were associated with the most diseases. One of the categories we looked at was cardiovascular diseases, where we found that the highest risk months to be born in was in the early spring, as opposed to respiratory illnesses, where we actually found that the highest risk months were in early fall. So then we looked at reproductive diseases, and we found that the highest risk months to be born in was in the early winter. We actually found the same pattern for neurological diseases. So it's important not to get overly nervous about these results, because even though I'm saying that there are higher risk months and we do find significant associations, the risk is not that great that you should worry about when your baby is going to be born or when you might have been born. And there's lots of other variables that account for disease incidence. And so what we're interested now in is actually expanding this analysis and really try to understand those other environmental variables. And we have some hypotheses that we're exploring, but we want to go in a data-driven way and explore all the hypotheses to find the environmental mechanism that might be driving these associations.